Our devotee was explaining that some people come to the program, you know, new people, they're not devotees, and then maybe they come a few times or they just come once and they don't come back, and they're asked, she's asking, what can we do to make them come back? And I asked, well, why are they not coming back? I think that's the first place we have to start. If some people aren't coming back, let's analyze why. Is it the way they're being treated? Is it the topics? Is it the way we're presenting Krishna consciousness? Is it that it's not relevant? Are we too heavy? Are we too narrow? Are we too strict? Are we too loose? Are we not explaining the philosophy well? Could be any of those things. So you want to analyze that. And the other thing you want to analyze is, are these people, were these even people that were capable of becoming interested in Krishna consciousness? Because sometimes we just attract the wrong people in our desire to get many people to come to hear about Krishna. We attract people who maybe aren't really that interested, and so we're investing a lot of energy in people that don't have potential. It's all about marketing, niche marketing. It's just like if you have a diamond shop, diamond and gold, you have to attract people who can afford it. And you can have 100 people coming into your shop every hour, but if no one can afford your product, it doesn't matter. But if you have one person that can afford your product, then that's your customer. So it's just as true in Krishna consciousness. I have experience of this. At one time, we did a program, and it was called the Bhakti Course, and we advertised the basic spiritual principles in Bhakti, and a Krishna girl came, and somehow she didn't understand that this was a Krishna conscious program, or Eastern religion. And she got really upset as we were talking about the program. And then I realized in the way we advertised the program, it wasn't really clear what we were doing. And it doesn't have to be extremely clear because you don't want to polarize people. Some people might say, no, that's not for me, without even trying it. And they actually might be interested if they came. So you want to word it in a way that would be of interest to as many people as possible. But you don't want to word it in a way in which people will come and they'll sit down and we'll find out that they're not interested at all because the advertising was misleading. So it's important to be able to find and attract people that are interested. And then once they come, if they are interested and they don't come back, then it's our fault. Then we were not sensitive enough to where they were at, to their needs. We were not expert enough at explaining the philosophy, inspiring them, enticing them. So someone might say, well, yeah, you know what, I just preached. I preached the truth, so it's their fault. That could be, but it could be our fault because someone else could preach the truth and encourage those people. So ultimately, you really want to judge by the result. Some people criticize a certain kind of preaching. And Prabhupada's response to that was, well, show them how to do it better. But if you can't do it better, what's the use of you criticizing? And if you can do it better, you don't have to criticize because everyone will see the way you're doing is what you're doing is working. So really, we want to judge by the result. And if we're looking at our results and our results aren't good, we have to ask these questions. Is it the wrong people? Is it the wrong presentation? Am I too strict? Am I too lenient? Am I not relevant? Am I too philosophical? Am I not aware of where people are at and what they need? These are all powerful questions, and we can discuss that amongst our group and analyze as we would in a business. What's working, what isn't working, and whatever is working, do more of, and whatever is not working, then just let it go. Maybe it worked 50 years ago, and it's not working now. Why keep doing it if it's not attracting people? It's something we didn't do 50 years ago, but it's attracting people to become more Krishna conscious, then we should do it. That's just how it, just how the world works. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.